Well, I was on my father's lap when I was about three. He was a drummer in wedding bands throughout the 80s, so I kind of grew up with music on a day-to-day basis.
You did drumming in school and stuff, too, I assume?
I did, of course. By the time fifth grade came around, they asked you what you want to play. Of course, they told me I should play trombone. And I basically told, no, I'm a drummer. I know how to play drums.
When I was a kid, my parents, I told them I wanted to play drums, too, and they're like, nope, you're going to be playing something a little less noisy than that. So I'm glad your parents were much more understanding.
Yeah, I'm sure it drove them crazy.
So then when did your first gig happen, man?
I was in 8th grade, 9th grade, 14, 15 years old. Started going out helping my dad set up PA around Syracuse, New York. One day, one of the local drummers needed a sub, and my dad vouched for me. And sure enough, I did it, and they ended up letting go of the old drummer at the time, and they brought me in as the full-time drummer. I just always knew I wanted to play, and I was making money at 15. I played like 20 weddings that summer and paid for my first car, my first drum set, and things just snowballed through the years. As I got through my 20s, I realized you can only be a big fish in a small pond.
That's right, yeah.
So long before you kind of get tired of it, so I chose to move to Nashville. From there, things really snowballed, because once you're in the middle of the music industry, you kind of, it's like a ping pong game. You just go bouncing around and seeing where you end up.
Well, sure, because for a lot of people, they'd make that pilgrimage, and it doesn't turn into anything for them. So what was different for your recipe?
I'm really a personable person, and I enjoy making people happy. More importantly, I enjoy drumming.
And I can tell from personal experience, man, you were definitely energetic behind that kit. You were always happy, and you're like the Tasmanian devil back there. So.
Something about that still that I think John Fogerty is interested in. And I bring something like that to the table. And someone that his caliber and his age, even, I think it's refreshing to have that spirit there, you know?
And how did you hook up with his band? Because you've been hanging out with the Freddie Jones band in Chicago for a while now, right?
Yeah, I have. I've been with them for a little over 2 years. And
okay. Say
7 years ago, a local guy, Tim Shad, asked me if I'd like the opportunity to do merchandise for John Fogerty. And at the time, he was like, well, of course. I mean, no, I don't want to do merch, but I really want to put myself in the scenario to get an opportunity someday. And then last February, he asked me to send him a video audition of me just jamming along to some CCR songs. And a couple months later, I was able to go out to his house and played a couple private shows. It went really well. You know, I've been blessed to watch Kenny Aronoff play drums with John for so long that I really took a lot of what he did and what he used to tell me. Things escalated quickly, and I'm now the drummer, literally filling the shoes of someone I used to listen to on a day-to-day basis on all those number one records he played on. The fact that I'm the guy looking down at the crowd now is baffling. Going really well. I played at SPAC this past weekend, and that was my 8th show with him. The first run I did with John, we did 7 shows in a 10-day stretch. And then I finally got to go home last week for 4 days before back up here in New York. Well, I'm very into like taking care of myself and working out, staying like conditioned so I can perform at that level. So I typically wake up, I go for a jog, you know, like a morning meditation kind of thing. By then, catering's rocking, and so I go to catering and shower up, and before you know it, sound check's here. It's like 1 or 2 in the afternoon. From there, John comes in for sound check, like 3 or 4 typically, and we play for like 45 minutes, and we do dinner, rest for about an hour, get dressed, and you're ready to hit the big stage.
And off it goes.
Yeah,
it's cool, man.
And it's on 10 the whole time. It is rock and roll. He really works the drummer. That music is so driven. The beats themselves are, you know, simplistic Americana grooves, but there's a lot of spirit involved.
Can you describe what that felt like to be up there on that drum riser looking at that crowd?
At first, it was a bit overwhelming because you have this pressure of the expectation of not only John, but everybody's there to see you perform,
right.
You know? So it really, you either, like, rise up or you crash, you know?
Yeah, you got a job to do, man.
At the end of the day, that's just it. I trained my whole life for this. I'm not going to screw it up now. I slept really well that night because, oh, my God, I finally did it. I got to play, like, a massive show with a rock legend for my friends and family. I'm very grateful.
How do you top that? I mean,
well, you know, I'm just getting better and better by the day, and I get the board tapes every single night, and I go back and I make notes where I think I can personally improve, or if John has random notes, I take them real serious, and I go back and listen, and I'm learning to adjust to the bigger stage. That's really what it is for me, is taking like what I do and bringing it to a bigger level. Years and years of conditioning myself to be ready for that opportunity, and now that it came, I swear I'll hold on to as long as I can. I lost my mom 4 years ago to a crazy case of colon cancer.
Okay.
And that was like the fuel on the fire that really kind of put it over the edge for me, like realizing, wow, life's really short. I try to live every day to the fullest. And she was totally present the other night. I could feel it.
Oh, man, that's awesome. That makes it even more special knowing that, man.
It was a really special moment indeed.
How did you even get the nickname Goose? Never even asked you that before.
In middle school, we did one of those championship musical things at Six Flags, Darien Lake. Well, we were eating lunch, and there's a flock of geese huddling over by where, like, the French fries and the food were. Of course, I was that guy that ran out to the middle of the flock and slipped in some goose poop. And not gonna lie, yeah, I mean, I don't think it's anything special, but the story turned into a great stage name. So here I am, 32 now, and being called Goose all over the country.
What's up with the stuffed animals, man? How did that start, too?
Because I live on the road a lot, I thought to myself, I'm going to bring some of these animals out to remind me of home. Like,
oh.
I look over, and I'm in front of 5,000 people, I look over, and I see a little alien looking at me in the eyes. It reminds me, like, I'm home.
Right, exactly.
It's all good. I get a lot of comments on that on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah, I think I remember when we were playing together, you had a lobster or something?
It was a goose. I still have it, Lucy.
All right, Goose.
Love it.
Hey, keep rocking, man.
I will. I hope to be in touch again.
You got it. All right, we'll talk soon.